you're someone who writes articles either, you know, for work, maybe you are a content creator, maybe you're a writer, maybe you're someone who just likes to write articles and publish blog posts personally for fun, whatever the reason, if you write articles, I think this might be one of the most helpful videos that I've ever made for Reflect. So I'm going to give you a process that I use to write. I mostly stole this from Alex. He's a little better at it than I am, but I have started using this for my newsletter. So I'm going to go through this process and explain it to you, and then I'll actually do it through an interview that I just did. But to start, let me kind of run through what exactly I'm going to do. So I'm going to start by transcribing my thoughts, or in this scenario, it's actually going to be an interview. So if I'm just writing an article based on my own thoughts, maybe I want to write an article that's everything that I know about content marketing, then I might go for a walk outside or just walk around my house or something, and I'm going to start recording here. I guess it won't let me because I'm already recording on the other one. So I don't need to do that here, actually, but it would just record it and then put it onto your daily notes. And that's really nice because I can just kind of ramble. Doesn't have to be in any order. I can just extract all of the thoughts from my head about a topic into my notes. And that will just land as a huge chunk of text. And that could be, you know, an interview as well. So that's the example that I'm going to be going through, is interviewing another person about how they built a growth channel. It could be a conversation with someone that you could turn into, you know, insights, but whatever it is, some information source that I'm going to transcribe so that I have a big chunk of text that's waiting with me with all of the insight. But then I need to organize it. So I'm then going to take that big chunk of text. I'm going to organize them into key points and themes. It's not going to be an outline. It's literally just a bullet list of all the information that's taken in the article. And then I'm going to have it take the points and make it into an actual article outline. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, why do I need both step two and step three? Can't I just, you know, have it make an outline straight away? What I've found is that currently GPT-4, which is what what Reflect uses that I'm in right now, and also ChatGPT if you have Plus, and it's good at organizing the information, but when you ask it to create an article outline, it actually strips out the information and only keeps the themes. So if I describe this interview, you know, let's say it's on SEO, for example, and the interview describes how to do keyword research, and the other person's like, okay, so first you're going to want to go into Ahrefs, you're going to want to brainstorm keywords and XYZ. The AI will take that, and then the article outline will just write, describe how to do keyword research. But the information of actually how to do the keyword research is what I wanted to keep. And so that's why this step is really important. And then I guess the fourth one, I missed the actual important one, have AI generate a article draft using number two plus number three. Tweak as needed, doing this on the fly. So yeah, you're going to then take the actual key takeaways and the article outline. So the key takeaways are going to be the information. The article outline is going to be the structure. And then you're going to have it take both of those and write an article draft. You're going to need to tweak all of these steps. So when you transcribe, that's pretty much the only thing that's going to be done perfectly. You won't have to, you know, edit the transcription. But when you organize it into key points and themes, you're going to have to edit it. So some things it's just going to misunderstand a little bit. Other things, it'll be out of order. Some things might just not be relevant. Like if you're talking to someone, they're probably going to say a lot of irrelevant things. And so you're going to need to edit the key points and make sure only the good information is there. Great. Then you can do the article outline. Similar. You're going to see the article outline kind of just okay. So you're going to need to edit it, rearrange it, put it into the order. But the big one really is you must remember that when it generates the article draft, it's not going to be good. And this is why people kind of just glaze over their eyes when they hear AI and content generation, because they just think you're going into ChatGPT and saying, hey, generate me an article about content marketing. Some people do that, but the articles are terrible. It's not good enough where I can just do all the writing for you. But you can get this first draft and then you can tweak it. So what I like to do is I like to take the first draft and then I will actually record my real draft over the bad AI generated one. And then I've got my article. There's more stuff, like if you're keep it simple, like I could add a sixth one, which is then use AI as a copy editor. And there's a lot of different things you do, but this is kind of the rough workflow. And I wanted to emphasize that it's really not that many steps. And once you get the hang of this, I think the whole thing probably takes like 30 minutes. So let's go through an example. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pull in the transcription from one of my last interviews on a newsletter. It's a conversation that I did with the founder of a company called NeighborBright. And I'm going to show you my process. So let me pull it in and then we will get going. Okay, so here I am in a note that has the transcript. So you can see this is actually from Google Meets. So it has the speakers separated, which for this particular interview format is pretty nice. And I've just got the whole conversation here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of the text of this conversation. Well, it's a longer one than I thought it was. Usually they're only 30 minutes and it's actually not that long. So I'll take all of this information and then I'm going to pull up an AI prompt that just lists the interview key takeaways. Now, this is a custom prompt. There is a system prompt that just says list key takeaways. This is why I've created a special one, is because I've included special instructions in this custom prompt that tells it it's an interview between two people and that it's talking about a growth channel. And I'm telling it the key takeaways that I want it to extract. This is because if it doesn't know what the information you want to extract, it will just try and extract everything and it takes way more time to edit. So I recommend setting up a custom prompt that just gives the AI a little bit of context about what you're trying to do. And then here I can see that I've got the key takeaways that it's writing here. So it looks like it just finished there. So I'm not going to replace it. I'm going to insert it, which will then put it below all this, I believe. Yep, there we go. And so what I'm now going to do is I'm going to organize this into its unique section for key takeaways, and then I'm going to edit them. So just to give you an example, I won't show you how I edit the whole thing, but the initial business idea, I heard about this on the interview, but I'm not going to include it in the newsletter because that's not really that important to the growth channel. Pivoting to AI for their product, that's also not really that important. We only want to know what the growth channel is. Free AI designs as a marketing tactic. That's great. I want to include that. You know, maybe I come down here and at the end they start talking about, you know, like the interview concludes with me thanking him. I don't need that information. Here, you know, they start talking about the product. So maybe I want to move those to the top. So I'm going to go through and I'm going to organize these a little bit and I will come right back to show you. Okay. So what I've done is I've put them under a collapsible bullet here. And now I can see it. And I'm just going to, you probably saw below there, I'm just going to make each of these a section, like transcription, key points. And actually, let me go ahead and do this because I like a nice, clean looking note. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out the actual transcript. I'm going to put that behind this. So I'll probably make it a header 3. And then I can paste that underneath it. And now, since I don't really want to have to keep scrolling through all of that, nice and clean. Awesome. I'll make this a heading 3 too. So now I've got my key points. You can see there's a lot fewer of them. I've cleaned them up. This one at the bottom here, I put in some sub points just for final tips that were kind of miscellaneous one. And I did reorder them a little bit. So it's not yet an article outline, but I did try and reorder them so that it explains what the company is, what the growth channel is, and then describes it. So that's my key points. Now I'm going to actually have it create an article outline out of this. So same thing, I'm going to select the key points. And if I type in article, you can see similarly, I've got a custom prompt here to write it. Oh, that's the article. There we go. Newsletter article outline. Same thing. I'm going to pull this up. It's a bit of a similar story to last time, but you can see it's got some formatting suggestions that I copied from Reflect system prompt. So Reflect has a system prompt that says, write a blog post. I just copied that And then I just gave it some more context about formatting. I try and force it to include all the information, but it never does, but I still try. I try and give it, you know, the structure of orders. And I can do this because I do these interviews for each newsletter, and it's going to be the same rough structure every time. So this form works particularly well. Okay, and that's pretty much it. So once again, I'm not going to replace it because I want to keep those key points. That's very important. So I'm going to insert it. And then just like before, I'm going to do a little editing. So it inserted it because I had that selected. So what I'm going to do again is the same thing I did with the key points. I'm going to clean up the article outline, eliminate the irrelevant points, make sure I don't need to add any in, and structure it in the order that I want. And I won't make you watch me do all that, but I'll be right back with it organized. Okay, that was actually a little bit easier because it's kind of easier to read this organization style, but I've just broken it into the introduction that describes what the company does, how their marketplace works and their monetization strategy. Then I move into the growth channel, describing what it is and how it works, then move into how to build the growth channel, and then I do a conclusion. So now we're starting to get a really nice picture of this story here. I'm talking to this guy, he's describing to me the growth channel. So NeighborBright is a company that is a marketplace for contractors that do landscaping. They have a marketing channel where they let you to create free AI designs of your yard, and they use that as their acquisition tool. And their growth channel is connecting that to a distribution channel, which is direct mail, where they mail people postcards with an AI generated image of their own house. Super, super cool. And then they use an API to automate all of this, or most of it. And then we go through exactly how they did that. And of course, the conclusion. So this is now great. I've got my outline that I'm very happy with and the key points. So now for the last kind of writing stage, I'm going to select both of those, both the key points and the outline. Same thing. I'm going to write newsletter because I have a newsletter, write a newsletter article prompt. And similarly, this has some instructions. Some of the instructions, I keep missing it, are in vain here, and the AI doesn't do it that well. But, you know, I try and copy the reflect article prompt and then give it some, you know, basic instructions on formatting. Try and give it some instructions on tone, but it doesn't listen. So, you know, you can try tweaking it as much as you can. There's really only so much you can do. And I'm going to let it finish, and then I will insert it below and we'll come back to edit it. Okay, so now we've got our article draft here. You can see exactly my cascade: transcript, key points, outline, article draft. And if you started reading this, you're probably thinking, this is terrible. This first line just sounds like I wrote it, even though my comp explicitly tells it not to sound like AI. Sometimes that works, sometimes it doesn't. But this is honestly fine because I can now write my article around this first draft and I don't have to worry about it that much of, you know, the cold start problem. So what I like to do now, this is up to your preference. Some people might like to go in and edit directly. I like to read it and then basically voice my article around it. So like this first sentence, for example, neighborbright.com is revolutionizing the way homeowners reimagine their front yard. That's such a weird sentence. So I would record this and say, I can't because I'm already recording. Dang it, I forgot about that. Okay, so I would just record this. Imagine that I can transcribe it while I'm making this video. And I would record it and just say, NeighborBright is a company that uses AI to help homeowners reimagine their yards. And that's just like a little bit better. And then I'd say, you know, instead of a traditional pay per design model, NeighborBright lets customers design their yard for free as a marketing channel and make money off the marketplace. That was not very good. It's kind of hard to do this on a call, but I will kind of go through and speak the article. Sometimes I'll even do this off the outline. It can be a little bit easier. And then once I've finished writing my first draft based off my voice, I will come in here and use the system prompt and have it act as a copy editor. And that will sort of clean up my writing. And then I've got a pretty good draft. It really doesn't take that long. This video is about 15 minutes. And it most of the time with me explaining the process, not actually doing it. If you're actually doing it, it's really, really fast. I think even with all of the editing, you can go from idea to finished article in about 30 minutes. So is this how you're probably going to write a book or like your Paul Graham style article? Probably not. But is this how you're going to write your newsletter articles? It's how I write mine. And it really helps you produce more content faster. I mean, I think, you know, depending on what content you're creating, you're going to have to tweak the process, tweak the tone, tweak the length. But it's a really, really great way to start. Even if you never have it do this last step where it writes the draft, just having it do the key points and the outline based off an audio memo of your own knowledge is just such an incredible process. So I highly encourage everyone to try this, even if you're not someone that's used to being a writer. You never know. Maybe it'll turn you into one.